neck to the net, right? Well, I wouldn't if I were in your shoes. Corporations say the new net is safe and secure. That they've learned from past mistakes. From up in their ivory towers, everything must look all nice and pretty. But they're wrong. The net is just a rusty car with a fresh coat of paint. A heap of dog shit spritzed with perfume. The demons we released into the net have not gone anywhere. Deadly viruses, artificial intelligences that exist only to destroy. Netrunners consumed in the net's tangled webs, their minds lost to the void. Have you heard of the Prison of Souls, about Walt Cunningham and the Soul Killer? No? Well then, buckle up, because I've got...
Huh. Netwatch never sleeps.
Thank you. Hey, V. Come on in. Pizza's getting cold. We're in the kitchen.
You made it. Good. Grab a seat. This is Roxanne. She's worked at Clouds longer than any of us.
Hello.
Respect. The feat in itself from what I've seen of the place.
Just been lucky, I guess.
Just eat the free pizza and then we're out of here, okay?
How are you?
Okay, I guess, but, you know, sad as hell.
Were you and Evelyn close?
Yeah. Blew up in her face when she showed up back at Clouds. She was supposed to be long gone, the one who got away. But deep in my heart, I was glad to see her back. She likes such a gunk now.
You'll never get rid of the stench of the corpse. You drop a lot of them, don't you? What's your secret?
Suddenly comes naturally to you, doesn't it?
Yeah, odd, given how much work I gotta put into it. By the way, Forrest is doing fine.
Is that so? Well, you're his boss, so guess that should make you happy.
What you're saying is he'll remain in good health.
Yes. Done saying hello to each other? Revolution won't plan itself. I modified the behavioral chip. It can equip any doll with a motor reflex system. In other words, make the doll move and fight like a prim-tier solo.
Fascinating, isn't it? What one can learn while tuning fake orgasms for the moxes.
Mind stepping outside? Can't smoke in here.
You'll air it out later. Fine. I'll sit by the window.
The body'll react as if executing a well-trained series of movements. Already tested it out on Tom. Chip's impulses supplant any natural reflexes, so it'll make users feel like they're experiencing cyberpsychosis.
But it's basically the same as when we activate ourselves for a client.
Solo skills don't lie in just executing movements. They're split-second processes that happen. Logistics, decision-making, result of years of practice. Doubt your chip's capable of compensating for that.
You're probably right, but I don't see another way. Alternatives intensive training, but we don't have time for that.
Tech that's all pros and no cons, I don't buy it. Side effects, spill them.
Combat mode auto-initiates when a threat is present, and there's no way to stop it. Can't find a workaround.
And that's it?
I don't know. Only way to determine that'd be through months of testing on a range of subjects.
There's an ethical side, too. You could murder someone and not remember a thing.
How'd you ever come up with this?
Learned how the behavioral chip works at Clouds. Always seemed like they must be pretty easy to modify. I'm surprised I didn't get the idea the moment we walked into Maiko's office.
Count yourself lucky. What with all the cams and mics and Clouds? Tiger Claws would sooner dig those chips out of the dolls with screwdrivers than let an idea like this run its course.
All right. Gotta see it to believe it.
Finally, someone said it.
Tom? Pulled that sequence from a kung fu training virtue.
Accept,
not convinced. If I'm to count on ninja dolls, I'm gonna need to see some real action.
Like, wanna spar?
What else?
Just don't mess up my digs, okay? I like it here.
It's on now!
What the?
Everything chill? You okay?
Ha! Look at me go! You see that? Woo! Gotta do some
nice
cardio!
Nice work, Judy. Outdid yourself. If you were to sell that, you'd be the richest Judy in the NUSA.
Please. Plenty of killing machines in the world. I don't want to turn more people into them. After this, chips are getting micro-nuked.
If you got something to say, just say it.
Who, me? This is my impressed face.
Okay. That probably sells it. The chip works.
Let's get to it then. You've got an elite force of three muscleheads and a techie. What now?
Guards and tiger claws in and around will overpower. Take down. Disarm. Escort them out. Clouds will be ours. Bosses, we'll give an ultimatum. A cut of the proceeds in exchange for never showing their faces at the club again. And having no say in how the club's managed.
That's what I thought. A half-baked, insane plan. You can't see more than an inch ahead of you. Taking out the security there won't solve anything. Claws will just send more. Hiromi Sato is the man you gotta get to.
Hiromi Sato? Who's that?
Cloud's real boss. He rarely shows, but you can't so much as sneeze without him finding out. Claws trust him, respect his opinion. He is one of them. We can try to convince him, but it's doubtful. We stand a better chance by injecting him with a dose of fear.
Where do we find this Hiromi?
At his apartment. H8 Mega Tower. Topmost floor. It's a penthouse. Almost never steps outside its glass walls. But I'll figure out a way to get us inside.
Tom and Roxanne gonna come with?
No. Whole point's to strike both places at the same time. They'll take care of business at Cloud's.
Two-pronged assault. Loving it.
Wouldn't it be better to ambush him in the street, like, while he's chomping on a scop dog or taking a piss in the back alley? Why even try breaking into a penthouse? He's probably crawling with guards.
Hiromi don't go anywhere without security. So one, makes no difference. Two, this is only a show of force demonstrating what we are capable of. Which is a lot more than street thuggery.
So how about it, V, Tom, Roxy? Made up your minds?
I need to think about it. Never wasted anyone before, you know.
I'm with it all the way.
V?
Don't tell me you're seriously considering this. Sticking our precious necks out for a bunch of whores?
What's up with you?
I'd rather not have to flatline anyone.
What he said.
Hope is it won't be necessary.
Overpower Hiromi. Humiliate him. Should be enough. Bosses will put him out of the game.
Count me in, Judy. I already said I'd help, didn't I?
Thanks, V.
Save the gratitude for later, please. I'll set up the meet with Hiromi and let you know. I need a couple days. Have fun. Toodaloo.
Michael, hold up. Give us a lift.
Only if you don't talk to me. I feel a migraine coming on.
Oh, shit. I'm scared, V. Speaking of gratitude, stuff I'm asking you to do, well, usually comes with a price tag, I know. You want to help, I get that. But I'm more than happy to pay your fee in full. Feels like it's only right.
All right. Thanks. Nice of you to think of that.
Don't mention it. V, everything okay? The?
Okay. Okay, I'm better. Fine.
What the hell, V? You, like, sick?
Remember the heist Evelyn hired us for? The relic I was gonna collect.
Couldn't forget that in a million years.
That biochip. Well, long story short, it had Johnny Silverhand's mind on it. An engram of it that's overriding my mind.
You being serious?
Truly wish I wasn't.
Fuck. Anything at all you can do?
One can hope.
It's late. You're tired. You can crash on my couch if you want.
Sounds great. Thanks.
Don't worry about it. Make yourself at home.
Ugh. Interesting.
Place looks like a fucking antique museum.
Then I guess you should feel right at home.
Chick's got taste.
That all you have to say?
And she's nice. 6 out of 10.
Didn't know she dabbled in robotics.
Now that's fucking shimmer. Think that's how she winds down?
After a day's work of tuning hardcore smut? Wouldn't be surprised. River.
EB, hey. I need your help.
NCPD asking a freelancer for help. Things gone that far to shit?
I should talk about this on the holo. We gotta meet.
When and where? Tell me.
Glenn, tonight. I'll flick you the details. Will you make it?
Do my best.
Thanks, V. Till then.
Welcome back. So, ready? Rogue should be here any minute.
Okay, one more time. You're just gonna talk to Rogue about Smasher, right? Then you'll hand me the wheel and hop back in the passenger seat.
That is the plan. Don't worry. I'll be gentle. You might even enjoy it.
Actually, regretting this already. You're gonna strum her guilt, squeeze her for favors. Remind her all about how she left you to die in Sackett Tower.
First, she was sure I was dead already. Second, I'd never do that to her. Don't have to.
What? You gonna use your charm?
Rogue's never said no to me. Ever.
Okay. I'm ready. About fucking time.
Look a little different. Fuss with your hair or...
Fuck, it's good to be back.
Never knew you'd gone off somewhere.
What's your poison?
Tequila old fashioned. Top it up with beer. Just sprinkle in some chili.
Silverhand special. Been a while since anyone ordered that.
Give me another.
You got it.
She's Ryder. Name mean anything to you?
Mm-hmm. Tattoo guy. How do you know the name?
We go back. Where'll I find
her? Got a salon in Watson, Pershing Street.
So what'll it be? Billy Goat or the other one?
Other one. He's gonna love it.
Sure he will. Jeremiah Grayson. Heard he's an operator for Smasher. But you didn't hear that from me.
Hey, who are you again?
Yeah, could say we had something in common. Ruby Collins. Sloppy second for Grayson after I banged her.
Drink slinger.
You've heard about me?
Let's get out of here. Tell you what I heard, then you'll show me if I'm right. Just got a little biz to take care of first.
Yo! Get your fucking paws off Ruby! She ain't going anywhere with you. She's on that clock, got it?
Fuck, I missed this. Be waiting outside.
You waiting for me?
Let's go back to my place. Take the long way.
Look good on you. Got a light? I'll call.
Ruby, focus. I need to talk to Grayson. Hello, Night City.
Spit blood first thing every morning.
Talk about something else, please.
Sure. First time you walked up, sensed there was something familiar about you.
Blah, blah. Johnny told you.
Gonna make me wait all day.
Did we?
No. Gonk was too drunk. He called me early morning. Of course, I thought it was you. And I thought, cute kid. Too bad he's gone completely whacked.
Came to see for yourself, huh? Morbid curiosity?
Mm-hmm. And I found Johnny Silverhand.
Feels, weird. This. You knowing about Johnny.
Face is changing, you know. Still look like V, but that mean smirk, I'd know it anywhere. How he talks, moves, how he smokes.
I don't smoke.
I know. Could never confuse you two. So sleep soundly.
Smasher. He tell you about him?
Yes. Didn't know he'd come back to NC. Johnny found some way to get at him.
Wait. Grayson.
Jeremiah Grayson. Works for Smasher. Johnny got a tip off some stripper, don't ask me how. Ebonique. Just that. Still, let me see what I can do. We're gonna get that son of a bitch.
Know what Smash has been up to all this time?
Disappeared after the Sokka Tower assault in 2023. All thought he was gone for good. Then suddenly reappeared. Did a few Mondo jobs for Arasaka, then went right back to ground. Nobody's seen him in years. Except Grayson, apparently.
Can I help at all?
In your state? You're useless. Almost. I'll buzz you when I learn something.
Okay.
Unbelievable, that bastard's somewhere in your head.
The pills would lay you out like this.
Maybe it wouldn't be bad if you hadn't chased them down with fuck knows what. You ought to be the one puking right now.
Yeah, well, life ain't fair.
Yeah, you sure picked the right moment to bolt out of my body.
Ought to be happy I left it all.
Oh, I am. Look at me. Spewing joy and rainbows.
Like a fucking ray of sunshine. Well, we moving?
The hell is this place?
Place where you can puke all over the carpet, no problem. Beggar, not chooser. Thank you. So, feeling better?
No.
So, as I was saying... Let's make this quick. Let's make this quick. Let's make this quick.
Jefferson?
Listen, I need your help again. Matters private.
Sure, okay. What's it about?
Not on the Hollow. Come by. I'll lay it out. Explain everything. Why is there no eagle?
Got your back, Jefferson. Not to worry.
Great. We'll see you here then. Remember where?
Of course. Be there in no time.
Mierda! Shit! I ain't the only one losing it here!
¿Qué chingados te pasa?
¡Ya! ¿Qué tuvo? Shit! I ain't the only one losing it here!
¡No te escondas, puto! ¡Sal de ahí!
With lead.
Why do you need the rig?
Fucking love that corpo chic.
Wait, seriously?
Who guards the border?
Well, Militech.
Now connect the dots.
What the hell are you thinking? A Solo making an exchange with the Valentinos?
I wasn't alone.
Well, what happened?
The motherfucker set a trap. That's what happened. Fucking Tinos.
And this surprises you?
Man, whatever. I'm out of here. Worst trip to the city ever.
Sublime work, Lee. I know I can count on you. The Nomads are grateful for your help. Contract closed.
Attention all NCPD subcons. APB out for suspected organized crime activity on Skyline South. Primary target is Denzel Cryer, aka The Brain. Cryer leads a subgroup of the so-called Animals Gang, known to traffic the illegal supplement commonly called juice. City's got a reward on offer for neutralizing Cryer and his entourage.
Thank you.
touched.
Now fuck off!
I will personally find you and bury you!
What the? An uninvited guest. I don't know who you are, but I know you're making a very, very big mistake.
You fucked up. Bad. Girl was poor, so you figured even the junkie on the corner wouldn't give two shits.
Slow down! What do you mean? What girl?
The one whose blood was all over your limo.
Oh, that! Whew! I thought one of my competitors sent you. Look, this is all some gonk misunderstanding. I'm insured for accidents. Compensation's already been paid out. Case closed. And as for this job of yours, I'm sure we can come to some kind of professional understanding.
30 seconds, change my mind.
Someone paid you to take me out, right? Her mom, dad, fiancé, whoever. I don't know how much they promised you, but I'm certain my safe has more. A lot more. You let me go, everything in there is yours. And I'll transfer somewhere else in the city. Nobody, your fixer included, will have to know. It's a win-win.
Only place you're going is to the morgue.
Hey, don't come in.
I need you to grab some goods. Rare ones, candy rods. Fell into the hands of a junkie who's got no clue what they're worth. I couldn't bear to see them go to waste. Read the attachment and get to work.
Nah, you're just jealous. Just got up a little earlier, worked a little harder.
Thank you.
lost it up there, you know? I know! It's awesome, right?
Place. Tick, 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 tick.
Hey, V.
How you holding up? Nice ride. Brand new?
Nope.
Not in a chatty mood, I see.
Not really. Sorry.
So, what happened?
Needed someone to talk to.
Uh-huh.
First, take a look.
Hello, my name is Arif Iqbal, and this is WNS.
More dead politicians.
Today's story.
Just watch it.
A routine roadside inspection led the NCPD to the trail of a dangerous abductor and murderer. The incident occurred at the intersection of 7th and 15th Avenue. The following police footage was captured at the scene. 1038, I repeat, at 1038. Registration 2AA6244. We're exiting our vehicle now.
Copy that.
Out of the car! Hands up! Easy, officer. Relax. Shut your mouth! Oh, shit. We have a 1053 and a 1054. I repeat, a 1053 and a 1054. The boy from the footage is LeVar Martinez, age 17. His parents reported his disappearance over a month ago. Unfortunately, LeVar's life could not be saved. His body could not withstand the severe septic shock he suffered. Autopsy reports reveal the teenager was given dangerously high levels of hormones, anabolic steroids, and stimulants. The possessions and genetic material of 7 other missing teens were also found in the car, belonging to one Anthony Harris. Unfortunately, their fates remain unknown. Although the criminal widely known as Peter Pan survived the gunshot, he has not...
This, Peter Pan. He in O-Case? You were looking for him?
Never heard of him. Didn't cross my desk.
What's the problem if they caught the guy?
My nephew, Randy, disappeared not long past. And what you just saw, the kid was wearing Randy's shoes.
Ah, Jesus. Randy's disappearance. You know anything else?
My sister and I don't get along that well. I don't know much. Just wish I could have been there for her when she needed it most.
And what, they figured you'd get emotional and kept you off the case?
More like a restraining order. Won't let me anywhere near it. Gonagall took the lead on it. Lazy ass gonk. And so far, he ain't accomplished shit.
No way I'd let this lie.
I know. And that's why I'm asking for your help.
So what do we need to do?
Can't interrogate the guy because he's a veg, but we can view his dreams.
I'm sorry, dreams?
You heard me. Come on, I'll explain on the way. It's an experimental procedure, but it's already yielding results. They record dreams that can be played back as BDs.
Got access to these dreams?
Not yet, but they keep them in the lab we're headed to now.
Got an appointment?
Not exactly. We'll go in together, but, not through the main entrance.
We're gonna break the law?
We'll find a different way in, and then hustle out quick. Never actually been here, so I'll need your help. Lab's in the middle of an audit, so make all the noise you want.
How are we gonna find this brain dance?
Look for a room where they edit the dreams of autistic kids. Oh, and remember, Peter Pan's real name is Anthony Harris.
They definitely don't store any EPDs in this area.
Locked. Can't get in.
Hey, River. Think I got it.
Found something?
Not yet.
Anthony Harris, let's try these drawers.
Say, River, why not just have a janitor crack a door for you?
Can't risk getting scolded for sniffing around somebody else's
River.
Case. Yoan!
What are you doing here? You got kicked off the force!
Just suspended, actually.
What does he mean by that?
He hasn't told you?
Yawen, please, listen to me.
Aren't you in enough trouble already?
Harris kidnapped my nephew.
I'm sorry. Really, I am. But we store evidence here, and we have strict protocols.
Protocols? I'm talking about his nephew's life here. A child's life.
This is an ongoing police investigation. Go, please. Get out now!
Listen, you work with badges, right? You know what they're like. Feed them analysis, they'll shit out failure.
This type of thinking is the very reason we live in a lawless city.
Lawless? Remember your first med school exam? You know the one.
Passed it with flying colors. Gotta remember it. Ladies' room erupted in flame. They evacuated everybody for 2 hours.
I cannot believe you would throw that in my face. I never wish to see you here again. Especially you. You don't know him well, do you? This man is a bastard.
River and I get along. We're friends. Hasn't let me down yet.
Huh. I thought us friends, too.
Is that why you're refusing to help him out?
Harris is dream, Beatty. Where is it?
He isn't dreaming.
What? Why?
A bullet damaged his cerebral cortex. We get only dissonant urges. Pieces.
I'd like
try audiovisual stimulation.
But he isn't on the spectrum.
A favorite song or movie helps you reach the kids. Might be worth a try.
I am aware of the similarity. Hypothalamus stimulation and hormone production. But Harris is not a child. I have never tried the procedure on an adult.
Any reason you haven't?
Because, unlike River, I went to med school and studied neuroscience. And not by reading about it over someone's shoulder on the metro.
Let's try it.
We don't even know his preferences.
I'll find something. That mean you're willing to try?
Just go. I'll open the front door for you.
Let's ride, V. I know exactly where to start.
Say, by the way, what do you know about biochips? Arisaka's relic in particular.
Well, it's designed to store a person's neural engram. Sorry. Just imagine copying over a person's memories and personality.
Right, I get that. More curious what happens if the stored engram overwrites the engrams of the chip carrier.
Overwrites? I'm not even sure that's possible. Why do you ask?
Nah, never mind. Not a big deal. Thanks.
Okay, let me hear it.
So, got booted off the force.
Suspended. Mayor's death stank to high heaven. Inquest into, kicked under the rug. So I made a fuss.
Not worth asking how you feel about that.
Nope. It's just, it's not easy for me to talk about what's biting at my ass.
Fair enough. Could tell me where we're headed, though.
To Joss's. Randy's mom. She thinks he just ran away from home. For now, keep the kidnapping between us.
Tell me about Randy. What kind of kid he is?
Petty theft, drugs, running away from home. That kind.
Cop uncles really see the best in you.
There are people who always find their way into trouble. Randy's one of them.
Where's Randy's dad?
Been a few years since he got popped. Gang war.
Great role model.
Josh was left alone with three. But she's as tough as weathered leather.
You gonna tell me why we aren't trying to find Harris's apartment?
It's a house. I doubt he's keeping his victims in his basement. Besides, we are trying.
Want to see if we can find some connection to Harris at Randy's.
Pretty weak lead.
Best we can hope for just now.
Not worried Yawen's gonna toe the line? Rat you out to her superiors?
Used to be friends. Doubt she'd do that. Plus, not that I'd use it, but I do know one skeleton she'd prefer remain tucked in her closet.
You think Yawen will actually help us, all things considered?
Yeah. These tiffs of ours always end up the same way. I'll tell you about it over a beer sometime.
Sign me up. We find Randy, then we find the bottoms of a few bottles.
It'd be my pleasure.
I'm through here!
Alright, this is it. Sure been a while. Used to come over every weekend, a long time ago.
And? Changed it all since?
Places like this never change.
Lovely neighborhood. Huh.
River, you either got business with me or news about my Randy. Wouldn't drag your butt out here if you didn't.
Joss, meet V.
So V, is this about my Randy?
Joss, I don't know how to say this, but Randy was abducted.
But he's alive, right? River! Tell me, damn it!
We're looking, Joss.
Here?
Arguing's not gonna help anyone.
He's my child. You got no place telling me how to behave.
Joss.
Listen, we need to look through Randy's things.
Why?
To find any lead we can. Trust me, Joss.
Just don't destroy anything. Randy doesn't like it when anyone pokes through his stuff.
Let's go, V.
The kids are playing outside. Tell them it's time to eat.
Hang in there, Joss.
What's on your mind?
Think it's good she learned the truth.
That's the trailer. Eyes peeled for details, eh?
Uncle River!
Monique, Dorian. Hey, guys.
Is this your partner?
Just a friend.
You gonna stay over?
We'll see. Your mom's waiting for you with dinner. This is their old trailer. Randy moved in when I bought him a new one.
Real hellhole. Like in my good old days.
You check around, I'll check the trash.
Got some kind of key here. Real fossil.
Not quite what we're looking for, no.
Tainted Overlord.
Favorite band.
You know him well.
He used to send him an album every year for his B-Day. Jeez. Can still see the nicks from those first years we measured the kids.
Some kind of game here. Shipping code on it.
Left his favorite hoodie in the closet.
Expensive tech. Randy had to scratch for this?
You're joking. No chance Randy could afford hardware like this. Way too pricey. We gotta get in. But I doubt anyone knows the password. Can you crack it?
Let me give it a shot. Don't know how, River.
Damn. Need to try to guess it then. What could he have? Come on, V.
Who's the girl?
His ex. Natalie.
Ex in the pic. What's her name? Natalie?
Gonna have to keep trying.
Let's move. The Caldo's jacket?
Let's go. Keepsake. Used to be his dad's.
Maybe Al the Caldo's? His pop's jacket?
Not working.
B. Randy looks like his tag.
Mm-hmm.
Give his tag a try. B. Randy.
That's not it.
Woohoo, Liberum Arbitrium. Dark shit.
Sound could use work, but you can tell they put blood, sweat, and tears into it.
Punch this track title. Liberum Arbitrium.
That did it. Help me have a look around. Something deeply fucked about that cartoon. My skin's crawling.
They caught Harris in a vehicle like that.
Blockaded street. Shit, River. I remember that day. He lives close to an old school. True angel of empathy, this guy, huh? Figured out Randy's identity. Sent him the game as a present.
The one you found in his drawer?
The same. Shipping code suggests the prick sent it from the Badlands.
This guy baited Randy like a pro.
River, do you? Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
No. There's no way. Why would he do that?
Not only did they agree to meet, but it looks like Randy was as excited as any kid on his way to a theme park.
Fuck. This creep definitely scrambled Randy's head.
Natalie must have been the only person Randy trusted.
Can we view this page with a link? Some kind of link. The one Randy wrote about?
Let's find out.
Thank you.
hidden page set up by Anthony Harris.
Christ. I'm gonna be sick.
There's a file here.
Deleted, looks like. But the name's still there.
That name. Wasn't the video file on Randy's comp called something like that?
Hey, look. The name of this cartoon matches the missing file on Harris's page.
That's what we needed to find for Yawen. V, we've got it.
Randy must have downloaded it.
Sure, but V, don't you get it? This could be the key to Harris's mind.
Here's hoping.
Hey, can you use any of that Netrunner magic to shake anything else out of this?
Could try to pin Anthony's IP address.
Got it.
Freddy can't do much more, though.
Perfect.
That cartoon, River. Could be what we've been looking for. You said yourself we needed something to get Harris to dream. Send it to Yawen.
Right. Sending it now. Okay. Says she'll get back to me by morning. And that I am a son of a bitch. And, come on. Let's grab a bite. Listen, let's not worry Joss more than we need to, huh? We're hot on the trail. We'll know more tomorrow. That's it.
Dorian, please.
But it really tastes like boogers!
Joss, we're finished.
All done. Off to bed, then.
We left some for you, Uncle River.
Thanks, Monique.
Tell me you found something.
I sent some evidence to the lab. There's a chance we could know where to find Randy by morning.
When's the last time you ate?
Yesterday.
Have mine. I'm not hungry.
Thanks. Maybe later.
River, tell me, and be honest. Will you find him?
River's a hell of an investigator. Randy's as good as found.
Won't give up until I do, Joss. Joss, You mind if he takes Randy's trailer for the night?
No. Sure.
Staying, right? You gotta help me see this through. To the end.
Of course I'll stay.
Find your way, all right?
Yup. Gonna hit the sack soon. Can't be easy raising three kids on your own.
Well, it wasn't any easier with my husband. In fact, the best days were when he didn't come home. There were times I wished he'd disappear for a month, just to not have him hang around.
That bad, huh?
His bike in the highway, that was his world. But at home, let me tell you a story. This one time he took Dorian into the city. Had some errand to run, just father and son. He came back that night, dead-ass drunk. Raging at me for calling the cops on him.
Did you?
River found him in some dive and brought Dorian home.
Must have been a relief then, when he left.
For weeks, I cried every night. My husband was killed. The father of my children.
I'm sorry.
Randy changed. He locked up. Not to mention the other two I still had to raise. Life was rough with him and without him. Sometimes there's no solution.
How'd he die?
Thal DeCaldos told me he died an honorable death. Whatever the hell that means. They showed me his body, where his face used to be. Couldn't see the honor in that.
Let's, change the subject. Hang in there, Joss.
V, wake up.
Not done sleeping.
Yawen called. It worked. The cartoon. He's dreaming.
You got the BD?
Right here. Slot it in. Jack into the computer. I want to see it on the monitor.
That doc of yours is quick. Not bad.
Report this. I hope you understand that. This isn't normal behavior. Anthony, you killed Liam's turtle.
He was sick. He wouldn't eat, stayed in his shell. I just wanted to help him.
By injecting him with HGH? What were you thinking? Is this something your father taught you? Good people took you in. Extended their trust. This is how you repay them? Your friend died. I understand. But that is no excuse.
Fuck you.
What did you just say? Okay, I've had enough. Principal's gonna hear about this. Your foster parents, too. I see. Like father, like son.
Don't you dare talk about my dad!
That's right, you little shit. I know it all. Farm failed. Dad put a bullet in his head.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! You can't talk about my dad, you prick! You can't! You can't! He was sick, weak. I just wanted to help him.
back at Harris's smart kid days.
This isn't normal behavior. Anthony. You killed Liam's turtle.
Keep a second. You want to eat? Stand up.
No excuse.
Fuck you.
This shooting. It was a case study back at the academy. Give me a sec to check which school that was. Laguna Bend. Oh, looks like the whole town got flooded in the 50s. Well, at least we know the general area where Harris lived.
Guess that'd be that. Trophy. Old one. Dated from 2042. First place in an interscholastic wrestling tournament.
Something?
I asked you a question!
I don't know.
Choline, I'm at thionine levels. See anything odd?
Too low?
You were supposed to check before school. What do you gotta say for yourself? Cow's gonna die because of you. Gonna kill it like you killed your mama.
I'm sorry.
Don't apologize, just dial up her hormones. And shut off that goddamn cartoon! How many times I gotta tell you not to leave it like that, hmm? Half the day I spent trying to turn that shit off.
Guess that'd be that.
Harris looks even younger here.
Where you going now?
sick, like the rest. Got no way to ID him. Kid's father was a real hard ass.
Looks like a cattle bioscanner. It's for checking vitals.
Come here!
Yeah, Dad?
Kids up.
I don't know.
And shut up! That gut! Get the cartoon!
Cattle injectors for hormones, antibiotics. People ate meat loaded with the shit.
How many
times I can tell you not to leave it like that?
Supplements in the feed for disease-free livestock. This might be the place, V. It's a recent memory. Gotta be his hideout.
And where are you up to, Mike? Come here, you rascal. You'll hurt yourself. Tony'll take good care of you. Easy now. Yeah, I'm whispering your helmet.
Got some cables. Got a clock, an hour to midnight. Looks like Peter Pan turned this farm into a goddamn final bastion.
Must have been an auto shop or something here at some point.
Hearing what I'm hearing?
Trash barge. That's the signal to dump. Has to be a landfill nearby.
Fuck me. He treats the kidnapped boys like cattle.
Look, another one.
Fire department cert stamp right here. City South. Perfect. Don't see Randy anywhere.
The terminal controls the pens. Gotta be another deck somewhere for the mines and turrets. Signage on the farm model points to Petrochem.
And where are you up to, Mike?
Hey, the Illuminated Towers. Promoting the Uscracks album that came out then. Colors changed every hour.
I think that might be it.
Okay, so where do we sit now exactly?
We know Harris still lives near an old school that's now underwater. You can see the NC skyline and the Uscracks towers from the farm. It's a few miles out. Farm's located near a landfill. We know that too. Shipping code on the game Randy got from Harris traces out to the Badlands. Harris's IP places him outside Night City, within a radius of a dozen miles or so. Those towers promoting the Uscracks album. Colors change regularly, once an hour. So we know the time.
11 at night.
Right. And that puts the farm east of the city. Southeast, actually. Stamp on the NCFD certificate was from the southern region. Farm model's a Petrochem design, so that eliminates any others. Which narrows it down to Edgewood Farm. That's gotta be our place.
So, we've got it.
Just hope we didn't fuck it up. Come on. We gotta go.
Get distracted. Gotta focus on the road.
Easy for you to say. That's my nephew out there.
We'll find him, River.
If I'd only known sooner how he felt. What was eating at him?
This isn't your fault.
I'm his uncle, Lee. And I wasn't there for him. Fuck!
Hold on.
up something!
River, this is the farm. We got it.
I know. Let's get to the barn quick.
Thank you.
Try just...
up tight. Need to find another way.
River! Come here, quick!
Oh, fuck. Too late for this one. You alive? Come on, come on. Eyes open. Help's on the way.
He's here. Ready!
Breathing. Good.
He's hanging in there.
Just hold on a bit longer.
V, shut down the machine. Can't unlink Randy otherwise. Randy! 1052. I repeat, I've got a 1052 at a farm south of the city.
Yes, send the fucking squad!
Yeah, relaying coordinates now. No, several, at least. Do it quick, dammit! Oh, and watch for automated defenses on site. They're substantial. Hurry, gotta shut it off.
Okay, all disconnected.
Check the others. Could still be alive.
Right.
Dead a few days already. It's okay. Don't be scared. We're here to help. You're a bit dehydrated, but you're gonna be fine.
Hey, help me with Randy!
Whoa, easy there, easy now. Hey, you're all right now.
Hey, help me with Randy! Need to loosen...
did it, River.
Yep. We sure did. But I'm not about to leave it like this. The horror that bastard inflicted. Can't let it go.
He's in a coma, in police custody. He's not getting away with anything.
He's still alive. So in a sense, he is getting away with it. Not for long, though. Gonna squeeze the life out of him with my bare hands.
No, River. Want that fucker's blood on my hands, too.
Appreciate your dedication, V. But this is between me and Harris. Gonna take him out in my own way. Amidst all this confusion.
Sure you don't want to help? They'll catch you.
No, they won't. I was a detective, remember? I know how to cover my tracks.
Just remember, say the word, I'm there. You can count on me.
Need a little time to myself now. But I'll remember.
Hey, we're ready for evac. Are you riding along or not?
Really, V. Thanks. Couldn't have done it without you.
Don't mention it. And holler if you change your mind. Or if you're just in the mood to holler.
Poor boys. All your years, ever seen anything like this?
8 years in the force. Nothing comes close. Beyond twisted.
Thank you.
Good time. upstairs.
Thanks.
It's good to see you again.
Something happened?
Come on. Jeff will explain everything. He's just about done prepping for the debate. I've rescheduled all his meetings out of the office today. The office meeting here, so nobody will bother us.
Mike, we're talking about the cornerstone of my platform.
Exactly?
I'm not doing a U-turn
You'll
just because
Nightcore...
No, I'm not sucking anyone's dick just so they can fuck me in the ass! Look, I gotta go. Make the amendments, we'll powwow later. V, glad you could make it.
Jefferson?
Grab a seat, please. I'll explain why I asked you to come over. We've had a break-in. Not the usual kind, though.
So unusual how?
A couple of days back, dead of night, something wakes me. A noise. I grab my pistol and come out of the bedroom. See a stranger. He looks like he's about to reach for it, so I pull the trigger.
Nail him?
No idea. My head started spinning and I passed out. No trace of him the morning after. I'd like you to find him. Find out what he wanted.
Why me of all people? Wouldn't you rather have a detective look into it?
Prefer to use tried and tested contacts.
Can't blame you.
Former mayor's death? You unraveled that mystery. I trust you'll be able to crack this one as well.
Notify the badges yet?
We don't want any buzz around this. No attention, whatever.
You know. NCPD's full of people who like the occasional stray Eddie.
If we reported a break-in, the media descend on us like a swarm of locusts.
No badges. Gotcha.
Of course, we notified SSI about the incident. Our private security.
Intruder take anything? Break anything?
Nothing missing.
I haven't noticed any damage either. Jeff must have scared him off before he could do anything.
Said you passed out.
That's right. Just after I fired.
What then?
Nothing. I woke up in bed the next morning. Killer headache to boot.
Any idea how you made it back to your bed?
Nope. None. Elizabeth's at a loss too.
What did the intruder look like?
I can't remember much. It was dark. He was wearing some sort of mask. Or was it an implant? Couldn't really get a good look at him.
Elizabeth didn't see him either?
I slept through the whole thing. Election season takes its toll on you.
Security look into this? Say anything?
This is where things get a little weird.
They claim there's no sign of a break-in or of a shot being fired.
Security cams didn't record anything. Guard outside didn't see or hear anything.
They suggested Jeff must have had a bad dream.
Convenient answer.
Liz gave security the day off, so I could call you in.
This, security outfit, SSI. Who are they?
Been on the market the last 15 years. They have clients across the city. If memory serves, they came recommended. An acquaintance. You think SSI might be behind this?
No clue yet. Anyone besides SSI come to mind readily?
Could be the same people who were behind Mayor Ryan's murder.
Or Weldon Holt, Jeff's opponent in the race. The polls have him trailing Jeff.
But it could be anyone, really.
Jeff has many enemies, a lot of them powerful. We could sit here naming names all day.
I see.
That's why I called you, V. I need you to find out what the hell's going on.
Anything else you want to tell me? Or think you maybe should?
Nope, that about covered it. Liz?
It seems like everything. It's unlikely we'll learn anything anyway.
Honey, please. I'm sure V'll turn something up. So, you got all you need for now?
Wouldn't mind taking a look around the apartment.
Of course. Liz can give you the tour. Gotta run to a meeting. As soon as you learn anything, let me know.
Come on. Let me show you around.
Right behind you.
We can start where Jeff spotted our uninvited guest. I have to admit, sometimes I get fed up with all of this.
Politics?
So far, we've managed to effectively turn down offers to work with Nightcorp, Biotechnica, Arasaka.
So far, you say?
If Jeff can get elected without owing anybody, favors or otherwise, that'd be the real victory. Jeff's office. Control room, storage, and flea market crammed into one. This is where Jeff saw our intruder.
And fired at him here.
Right after walking out of the bedroom. At least that's how he remembers it.
Bloodstains. Not quite scrubbed clean. Where's the blood from? It yours?
I'm 100% sure it's not ours. Maybe the intruders?
Probably. Bullet holes. Caulked up. Someone tried to patch up the bullet holes. Assuming neither of you had anything to do with this.
No, of course not.
Broken.
It was fine a couple days ago. We rarely use it, though.
Happened to the screen a lot, or to any of the others.
I don't understand.
What just happened a second ago? You didn't see it?
No? What?
Okay, never mind.
Christ.
I think we're safe putting your security at the top of our list of suspects.
They violated our privacy. Sons of bitches! Under my own roof!
Wonder how long they've been keeping this from you.
Too long. This ends now. I'm not letting any more of those freaks set foot! Ugh. My head.
Something wrong?
Don't worry about me. Do what you have to do.
Used meds. Intruder make a beeline here after Jeff tagged him.
Talking to yourself again?
More and more. Ever since this terrorist started stalking me. Odd. Tech's practically prehistoric, but it doesn't look older than a day.
Saw something like this back in the war. Transmitters. Militech was using them. Short-range UHF. Signal only travels line of sight, but it can't be intercepted.
Line of sight? Let's look around, see if we can't spot where our receiver's camping out.
Thank you.
What's it for?
Connected to the wall-mounted screens. Wonder where else these cables run.
Vote for Perales.
We've paid staffers in for the campaign out of pocket. And we keep all the campaign stuff here. It's cheaper that way.
Thank you. discharged booster.
Someone's been pulling all-nighters.
Department of Law at Asukaga, Berkeley. Classy. Got a vision on the receiver. Black van parked next to it. Gotta be our winner. Transmitter's within reach of our mystery van. Wonder if Elizabeth has ever seen the car. Way bigger than we thought. Jeff's entire campaign could be threatened.
Let me worry about the race. Just tell me what you managed to find.
There's a transmitter on the roof. It seems to be conveying a signal to a van out front. You know who it might be?
We never set up any transmitter. And I don't know a thing about any van, but my guess is it's SSI's.
Don't really see any other possibility, but we still don't know who they work for.
So what do we do with the transmitter?
Nothing just yet. Let me check the van first.
I'll wait here. Just don't tell Jeff anything for now, okay?
Sure, whatever. I'll call him once I know something more substantial.
That's fine. Just remember, it's the busiest time for Jeff right now. You can always come and talk to me.
Fine. I'll keep that in mind.
How about we take the wheels, V? That van could give us a slip any second. We could expose a Corpo conspiracy here, V. I'm telling you. They could be Corpo's spies, or who the fuck knows what.
Jam-packed with hardware. I don't think some seedy manufacturing folk won't detect any mods. They don't mass-produce trucks like those. What are they doing? What are they hiding?
Earjacking. Huh. Could be the security firm or government. Media scouting for dirt on the paralysis.
I got you!
Pierstead, we're in.
Couldn't ask the NCPD for better records than this.
Pictures, medical records, vulnerability to neuroplasticity. Some kind of database. Brain scans, the paralysis, biological casts, neuroplasticity.
Fuck. What about that? The blue shit.
Fresh neural links. They're not spying on them, Johnny. They're fucking with their heads.
Mean to say someone's literally controlling our upstanding politicians' minds?
Mm-hmm. Red blots are memory residue in the hippocampus region. See how they're bleeding into the blue?
So what are we looking at?
They're planting new memories in their heads, modifying their personalities. This is big shit, Johnny.
Fuck me.
Got other guinea pigs besides the paralysis, too.
Quick, download the data. Whoever comes looking for it, that's your suspect.
Shit. They're wiping the data. We've been made. Now they know someone's been in their database.
Wonder if they also know who.
You're gonna want to sit down for this. It's way bigger than we thought.
What is?
You're being brainwashed. Literally. They've scanned your minds, now using some kind of conditioning to...
Wait. Not on the hollow.
Right. I'll come by.
No. You and I, we need to speak alone. Know a little rum. In
right.
Japan town.
See you there.
Sending you the coordinates.
Will you sit? Please? Thank you for coming.
Why are we meeting here and not at your pad?
Because I have something to confess. In private. Not in front of Jeff.
Okay. Confess away.
I'm sorry. My nerves are shot. I can't gather my thoughts.
Wasn't that long ago since we last met? Something happened since then?
No, I mean, something did happen, though not recently. It's a long story. I don't quite know how to tell you. Where to even start?
Relax. No need to rush.
A while ago, I started noticing some changes in Jeff's behavior. His personality, he seemed to be changing right in front of me, becoming someone else.
How so?
He stopped reading, forgot the title of his favorite movie. Even his musical taste changed overnight. Once, I said we should visit his brother's grave, and he told me that he'd been an only child. That's when I started thinking something bad was happening. Something insidious. And not just with Jeff.
Notice any changes in yourself?
After some time, on several occasions, my friends pointed out that I was acting strangely.
That must have been hard.
It was. You know, it's at times like those you start to question reality.
So the whole time, you knew what I could end up finding.
I don't know who, how, or why, but they're changing us. That concealed room in our apartment.
What about it?
I'm sure I'd seen it before, but must have somehow forgotten. I find that terrifying.
Mention any of this to Jeff?
I tried. I did. But he's blinded to everything. He just laughed, said I was imagining things. He once brought up a vacation that we never went on, swear to God. He went on about it in such detail, I almost started believing him.
Could be just you who forgot. Maybe they wiped the trip from your memory.
Hell, I don't know anymore. Don't you get that?
You haven't told me the whole story yet, have you?
I saw a stranger in our apartment one night tinkering with the monitors. But I was in such a state by then that I didn't know if I could trust my own eyes.
So you didn't do anything?
I don't remember what happened. I talked to security the next morning.
Let me guess. Cams didn't pick anything up.
The guy just shrugged and said I must have dreamt it. He showed me the recording, of course. I felt like a lunatic. And then, the next day, I got a call.
Who was it?
Them. Whoever they are. There was a garbled voice on the other end. He never introduced himself.
And? You cut some kind of deal with him?
No. I was told that our perfect lives could fall apart at any minute. That I have my husband's safety to think about. After, there was no record of the call. It was as if it had never happened. So I'm begging you, V. Jefferson can't find out about any of this. Ever. His life depends on it.
You knew who sent the intruder, but just strung me along anyway, Liz.
I didn't have a choice. I didn't know what to do.
You wanted everything just to go on and flow on because it was convenient.
Convenient?
You got the perfect life. Prominent husband. You don't lack for a thing.
You think I'm having fun? You have no idea what it's like living like this.
What if you're just saying what they programmed you to say? Just reading off a script based on thoughts planted in your head.
All I know is, I love my husband, and I want him to be safe, and happy.
But that's what they want you to know.
You know what Jeff will do if you tell him? I know my husband. He'll start looking on his own. He can't find out about this. It'd destroy him.
Damn it, Elizabeth. Gonna ignore this? Somebody poking around in your heads?
What choice do I have? To get myself killed? Or see my husband dragged away from me?
Ask me to lie to my employer?
I'm going to tell Jeff that SSI was spying for his rival, Holt. You just need to confirm what I say.
And if I'm not on board?
You have a choice. Just remember, any consequences will not be yours to deal with.
You're truly prepared to fire SSI after the threats. It'd be brave, but risky as all get out.
What they're doing to us is one thing, but when you found that concealed room, I can't accept strangers spying on us while we sleep. Not under my own roof.
What difference does it make where?
I'll take full responsibility for anything SSI goes on to do. I'm just asking you not to get Jefferson involved. I'll add a meeting in Reconciliation Park to Jeff's schedule. He'll be waiting. Since I can't know if I'll remember this conversation tomorrow, I'm counting on you not to forget what I asked of you.
I won't. But that's all I can promise.
Goodbye, V.
Whole thing's fucked up, huh? Wouldn't want to be in her pants. Speaking of, overlapping memories, changing personalities. Remind you of anything? But hey, at least we know what we're up against.
No, this is different. You saw it yourself. They're purposely modifying their minds, individual thoughts.
Paralas make a damn nice next-gen puppet. Even in my day, there were whispers about this kind of stuff. Cognitive pattern fluctuators, remote neural re-networking. In layman's terms, gaslighting. The beauty is that everything's fair game. Subliminal TV signals, high-density emitters in your electric toothbrush, you name it.
So, in my pants, what would you do?
Some real rat bastards behind this. Someone's got to take them down.
Even by risking the paralysis' lives.
Fuck knows what kind of shit a mayor controlled by puppet masters could pull. But yeah, you could end up putting their lives at risk. Or not. Tough choice, V.
Mind if I just peruse?
If you're not gonna buy anything.
You're my teacher, nothing.
Where do you want? What do
Need to talk.
Yes, I know. Elizabeth filled me in. Sounds like I was right to hire a professional.
Elizabeth? What did she tell you exactly?
Didn't get specific. Just that SSI was spying for that son of a bitch Holt. Guess you got more, though. V?
SSI wasn't working for Holt. You're in deeper shit than you think.
Meaning?
Isn't it weird that you're a virtuous politician candidate?
Flattered, but no. Far from it. Though I try my best. What's this got to do with anything?
How many people can honestly say they don't strike deals with gangs or take Eddie's and corpse?
A lot, I'd like to think. They just haven't introduced themselves yet.
Almost like this city doesn't deserve someone like you.
I'm not paying you to make up riddles for me, so get to the point.
SSI's on the take for some unknown group that's out to control your lives. You know there's a concealed room in your pad?
Out with it.
They've got tech in there you wouldn't believe. These people know everything about you and your wife. They're watching your every move. Somebody's programming you and your wife.
Sounds like something out of the movies.
Saw your brain scans. They're tweaking your neural connections. This ain't no movie, Jeff. Been at it for a while, you and Liz.
editing your memories, your tastes, your views and beliefs even.
How could I not have known about this?
Your memories. Can't even trust those anymore.
If that's true, I'll never know what's real in my life and what's a lie, fabricated. Wait, the intruder. I have to find him!
Trust me, you never will.
First I'll find him, then I'll find whoever's behind this. Pull the curtain back on these motherfuckers and show them what's what.
Could show their hand if you're patient, wait long enough. Or use your mayoral powers if you get elected. As long as you don't forget all this by morning.
Sun Tzu's art of war? Feign weakness so your enemy may grow arrogant.
Don't see you doing much feigning, Jeff.
My God, I have to tell Liz!
Your wife knows everything.
Liz? How?
Figured it out at some point.
Elizabeth? No. She would have said something.
She feared for your life. Your daughter's life. Who could blame her?
Nah. Well, she's never kept anything from me. And she doesn't scare easily, believe me.
Got an anonymous hollow telling her to keep her mouth shut. So she did what the perfect candidate's wife would do. Protected her family.
I won't let them get away with this.
Is there anything else I can do?
You've done enough already, V. All that's left to do is wait.
So what now? You still want to be mayor?
Well, I'm not about to give up. I didn't run just to... I'll wait for my window, an opportunity, then make my move.
Isn't that exactly what they want?
Well, I'll give them more than they bargained for. And same with your Eddies. Take care, V.
Good luck.
And good night.
So, thoughts?
Somehow I doubt it's people who are behind this.
So aliens?
Very funny. You're too young to remember this, but not so long ago, people talked about rogue AIs prowling cyberspace.
So, not aliens.
Doesn't matter who. What matters is that guy decided to take up the gauntlet. My man.
Down here.